हेलो फ्रेंड, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर सिमित सुभाष रोकड़े, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर लेट पुंडलिकराव गवळी आर्ट्स एंड साइंस महाविद्यालय शिरपूर जैन, तालुका मालेगाव, डिस्ट्रिक्ट वाशिम। माय इंस्टीट्यूशन इज असोसिएटेड विथ संत गाडगे बाबा अमरावती यूनिवर्सिटी अमरावती। आई एम अ पार्टिसिपेंट ऑफ ऑनलाइन रिफ्रेशर कोर्स इन बायोलॉजिकल साइंस एंड टीचिंग scheduled during 15th to 29th November 2021, organized by UGC HRDC Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Marathwada University, Aurangabad. My roll number is 16. Here today I am presenting a seminar, and my seminar topic is in vitro production of haploid plants. Dear friends, we know that a concept of haploid plants. Generally, naturally, the plants which are observing or animal which we are observing in the nature, that is of diploid in nature. But whenever we are producing or creating a haploid plants, it means it is from the single parents only, a chromosomal set of the single parent only. So what are the best advantageous features of the haploid plants are, a haploid can mix the, you can see these pictures where you can see it can give rise to the bigger flower. It can give rise to the fruit in a bigger size. It means it will help you to enhance the quality with production. So first of all, we'll see what are the learning objectives of this particular seminar topic, or the production of haploid plants. So these pictures showing the laboratory organization of plant tissue culture where we are going to develop the haploids. So what are the different aspects we are going to learn here? First of all, that is the plant tissue culture. Second one is a haploid production. Third one is advantages of this haploid plant production. Then also it also have the disadvantages, so we'll definitely deal on that. And lastly, we will deal regarding the conclusion of this haploid plant production. So first of all, we are going to understand what are the different methods to induce the haploid production. So first of all, there is a androgenesis. So my dear friends, here we are using the chromosomal set of the male parents only. So from the microspores or the pollen grains, we are developing the plant, and here the female parental chromosomal set is not participating in this, that is called as androgenesis. Next one is a gynogenesis, where we are using only the female parental chromosomal set, or only egg is involving in the production or induction of the haploid plant, that is called as a gynogenesis. So next to that, we'll see the different methods. Here we can use the different chemicals. So by using these chemicals, we can have the alteration in chromosomal patterns, and there we can induce the different kinds of haploid plant production in the various plant species. So first method we are going to deal, that is the pollen or microspore culture. So we know that when the pollen grain or the microspore mother cell undergoes the meiotic divisions, and it will give rise to the tetrad, that is the four microspores are linked together after the completion of meiosis 2 division, and that microspores are utilized to culture the haploid plant production. So this particular diagram is showing how the microspores are going to be developed through the meiosis. So very first in this diagram, you can see the first number of diagram or first number of the cell is the pre-meiocyte, that means the cell which is ready to undergo the meiotic division. So later on it will convert into the pollen mother cell and it undergoes to the meiosis 1 and meiosis 2, and afterward it will give rise to the tetrad. These four microspores are linked together with the callous wall, and later on they are being released and gives rise to the free young microspores, and that microspores are utilized for the production of haploid plants. So later on we'll see the anther culture. So in very first, Datura inoxia plant was utilized for the isolation of anthers to develop the haploid embryos in vitro, and that was published by the Indian scientists, that is Guha and Maheshwari, in 1964 to 1966. So later on these are the very simple technique they used, and that technique was found to be very efficient to produce the anther culture. So it also have the different advantages on the microspore culture, that being very quick and very good for the practical purposes. So later on the anther walls has the influence on the development of the microspores in it. So next to that we'll see the flow chart that will gives us a very simple way to understand the how the we follow the different step to take the to undertake the practical for the production of haploid plants. So first of all you just have to collect the flower buds, and the flower buds should be collected from the anther that are onset of the flowering. So later on you just brought it into the laboratory and undergo for the surface sterilization of that blob collected buds. Then these place these anthers on the solidified vessel medium and kept in a controlled condition, and later on after 3 to 4 weeks anthers will grow to produce the haploid plantlets. So how they produce, here I am going to show you with the different diagrammatic representation. Very first it will develop the callus, which is a green color, that later on that callus will definitely that their sprouting will be observed, and upper ground tissue, that means the leaves are being shown. Next to that we'll see the plantlets were developed, then we undergo for the hardening, and then later on we'll go for the hardening techniques, and that plant will be shifted towards the greenhouse. Then there is the microspore culture technique is also which we can utilize for this purpose. So microspores we can isolated from the flower buds by observing it under the microscope, where exactly after the completion of meiosis 2 stage there are some tetrads, and some tetrads that were released to the simple microspores. So here in this diagram, these are the microscopic diagrams, and you can see these are the tetrads where the microspores are bonded with each other, and here you can see this one is the microspore, single microspore, that was that microscopic diagram was taken there. So you can understand the collection of these microspores, and later on these microspores were cultured by using these flow chart. First you have to go for the plantation of the healthy plants, then later on you harvest the flower buds, then later on you harvested flower buds took to the laboratory and go for the surface sterilization of these flower buds, then later on you go for the isolation of microspores, then later on you go for the pre-treatment to these microspores, and later on you culture and transfer these at the 25 degree centigrade in the dark conditions, then embryo transferred to the germinating media and kept in the culture room, later on culture transport for the shoot development medium, and then you go for the hardening purpose. Then protocol for the embryogenesis. here you just have to collect the bird from the healthy plants which you have grown in your garden, then select the inflorescence of the required size. For this you have to undertake the different scaling techniques. So later on you just separate the birds and select the required size of the birds through the different meshes or different isolating techniques. So later on the surface sterilization carried, then next to that you just squeeze the bird, and later on you just have to place it for the incubation in the appropriate medium. So after some time of the interval you will observe the development of the embryoids like this. So at last we will see the advantages of these haploids. A very first advantage is we can develop the pure homozygous line, which is not possible with the traditional hybridization method very easily. So you can use the hybrid development by using these lab techniques. We can release the variety in very short time, where we can say the early release of variety can possible with this. Even we can go for the hybrid sorting in the haploid breeding. So here we can go for the sorting purpose also. Even we can induce the genetic variability as whatever we desire for the particular characters. Moreover, we can induce the mutagenesis and we go for the new variety development. Here we can go for the generation of exclusively male or female plants. Here we have the choice whether which plants we have to select for the haploid production. We can utilize the male plants or female plant only. Here we can also go for the disease resistant development or insect resistant variety we can develop with the these particular techniques. Even we can go for the salt tolerant varieties by using these techniques, and we can develop the aneuploids also. Along with the advantages, this technology or this particular technique has the different kinds of disadvantages also, and these are: first one is the frequency of haploid production is a very low rate, hence the selection is often difficult, because it the combination of the chromosomal set and that setting is a very hard, and it requires the much more time, and we can set at a very low rate. The operation of the tissue culture to develop the haploid requires a high level of expertise and management. So you require a very skilled person and with a very proper management. Without management and without a highly skilled person, these techniques may not be possible. Beside these haploids, different ploily levels can be produced along with this. So one has to select very keenly the haploid plants by using the different advanced techniques. So next to that, there are some other disadvantages are too, and these are: their haploids with the deuterious traits frequently develop in the culture. The callus derived from the anther culture is usually determined to haploid production, detrimental to the haploid production. Even isolation of the haploids from culture is often difficult, since the polyploids outgrow the haploids. So there are some more disadvantages, that is the embryo derived from the haploids often get aborted. Many times that this can be happen. The haploid production is associated with high incidence of albino plants. So this is also one of the factor which makes the hazardous to produce the good plants. Doubling of haploids, that is called as a diploidization, may not always lead to the formation of homozygous plants. That is also a kind of difficulty which many a time we can face for the during the development of haploids. Even in vitro haploid productions is not economically viable, because it's very low success rate. Due to the very low success rate, it may not found economically very useful. And last but not least, we come for to the conclusion that it is a very important that various realms of the research disciplines such as a plant biotechnology, molecular genetics, as well as with the traditional plant breeding, that's why they provide the useful information regarding the recombination and genetic control of the chromosomal pairing. At very last, I would like to thank you. Thank you very much.